A heart attack is happening. What do you do? Okay, so what do you do if you think you're having a heart attack? How do you avoid having a heart attack? More importantly, what does it actually mean to be having a heart attack? Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Wagner. I'm a real life board certified emergency medicine physician. On my show, I'm here to answer all your emergent medical questions and clear up myths about certain illnesses. So what is a heart attack? It is a myocardial infarction, or MI. In other words, the heart requires its own constant blood supply of oxygen and nutrients, like any muscle in your body. The heart has arteries and branches that deliver the oxygenated blood to the heart muscle. If one of the arteries or small branches becomes blocked, suddenly a portion of the heart is starved of oxygen, which is called cardiac ischemia. If that no oxygen deal lasts too long, then the heart is starved and it dies. And then that's what we call a heart attack, or myocardial infarction, which means death of heart muscle. Why is this starvation happening? It happens just like the roof gutters of your house when it gets clogged up with a ton of debris and leaves, blocking the normal flow of water. Blood clogs up the blood vessel, preventing normal flow, thus starving the heart muscle of blood and nutrients. Another cause of a heart attack is a spasm of the blood vessels of the heart, which then shuts down blood flow to that part of the heart muscle. This is what we call Takotsubo cardiomyopathy, also known as the broken heart syndrome. What are the symptoms of a heart attack? Very generically, these include fatigue, weakness, and chest discomfort. More specifically, typical chest pain for a heart attack has the following type of characteristics: intense, non-stop pain for 30 to 60 minutes, substernal or underneath the chest bone type pain that radiates to your arms, jaw, shoulders, back, neck, all over. In some patients, the symptoms occur in the stomach with the feeling of indigestion or fullness. Ladies, listen up. You're oftentimes less likely to experience the classic symptoms of chest pain. Rather, you may feel a sensation of fullness in your chest or in your arm, neck, jaw, or back. Patients with typical heart attacks may have symptoms in the days or even weeks preceding the event. What's crazier, about 25% of all heart attacks occur without any previous warning signs. All right, who's at risk? A lot of people. Heart attack risk factors includes age: men over the age of 45 and women over the age of 55. Tobacco use, stop smoking. High blood pressure, and also if you have the high bad cholesterol or triglyceride levels. Other risk factors include obesity, or being severely overweight, diabetes, dealing with blood sugar, or family history of heart attack, lack of physical activity, stress, illicit drug use, and among other factors. How do we know, as a doctor or medical professional, that you are actually having a heart attack and not just something that looks similar? Well, if you come to the ER, we are going to do a lot of tests, such as an electrocardiogram or EKG/ECG. This is when we put stickers on your chest wall to see if there has been an injury to your heart, as well as blood tests specific for your heart, a chest x-ray, and sometimes other additional stress tests. A heart attack is happening. Uh-oh, you think you're having a heart attack. What do you do? Call 911 immediately. Get to the hospital ASAP. The main medications that may be given to you initially when you might be having a heart attack: aspirin, nitroglycerin, oxygen, and morphine, and a few others might be included. Remember, most heart attacks occur over several hours, so never wait to seek help if you think you're having a heart attack. Can you die from a heart attack? Yes, you can die from a heart attack. Heart disease is the leading cause of death in the United States. Approximately 500,000 to 700,000 deaths are related to this each year, making it the cause of an estimated 1/3 of all deaths. The death rate related to acute heart attacks is approximately 3 times higher in men than women, and is more frequently in African American patients compared to other patients. Treatment. So you or someone you know has had a heart attack. What are your immediate treatment options? The main intervention: coronary angioplasty and stenting. In this procedure, also known as percutaneous coronary intervention, or PCI, it's when the doctors insert a long thin tube or catheter that's passed through a major artery in your groin or your wrist that goes up into your heart. Once it reaches that blocked area, there's a special balloon, not the ones that you get at the fancy birthday parties. And that balloon is briefly inflated and then opens up the vessel. The doctor can leave a small metal mesh stent there. It's then inserted into the artery to keep it open long term, restoring blood flow to the heart. And the other post-heart attack treatment is coronary artery bypass surgery. This involves the sewing of veins or arteries in place beyond the blocked or narrowed vessel, allowing blood flow to bypass around that area so it continues to give blood flow to the other areas of the heart. How do you prevent a heart attack? Well, first things first, it's never too late to take the steps to preventing a heart attack. Take your medications and check in with your doctor when you're supposed to. Maintain a healthy weight with a healthy diet. Do not smoke. Exercise regularly. Manage stress and control the situations that can lead to a heart attack, such as high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and diabetes. All right, that's been your 5 minutes on heart attacks with me, Dr. Wagner. I hope I've cleared up some of the myths about heart attacks and helped you get a better understanding of this deadly disease. Make sure you leave me a comment on what medical topics you'd like me to talk about in the future, and make sure that you subscribe to this channel and turn on your bell notifications. That way you can learn when I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. Stay healthy, my friends.